going back to family, my eldest brother used to paint. He did painting on glass. I remember that when I was very young. But after that he gave it up. But there were others, you know, around who also painted. One of them was a family friend. And then there were those who did sort of signboard painting. One of my great friends was a signboard painter. He died a few years ago. So beside the school, there was that connection. It was something, you know, which was associated with home, where I painted. And brothers were also generally very supportive of the things that I did. They must have found it a bit different, even odd, I don't know. And my eldest brother was also very, you know, I think because he had tried his hand on that, so he was interested in that. So in a way the family supported my studying further, which none of them had the opportunity to. And in a way my father perhaps was by proxy, you know, going to a college. Nobody had gone to college. So he helped me in a number of ways. And Ravishankar Raval, as I mentioned, he was a very crucial figure. He gave me a letter first that you could go and study in Baroda. I didn't have the vaguest idea of what Baroda was, and I didn't know what I was going to do in Baroda. So I asked my classmate, son of the librarian of Birdwood Library, to sort of accompany me. And I remember we both traveled to Ahmedabad first. And where we went to residence of Ravishankar Raval. And it was lunchtime, he gave us lunch. Then he asked me, I said, what are you going to do? Where are you going to stay? In Baroda. I said, I have no idea. It was crazy, I don't know. I still don't know how I would have made it myself. So he said, okay, I give you a letter. Here is this photographer who is in a place, it is called Tower, Raopura Tower. And you ask him, he will put you up before you get some accommodation. I thought that I will stay in a hostel or somewhere, but you don't get into hostel until you are admitted. And I had to go through the what they call aptitude test. I had to give examination. So I took that letter and went to the photographer, and he was, I think, a bit confused, but then he couldn't refuse Ravishankar Raval because he had asked him to put me up. So he said, I don't have any place for you to stay, but here is my studio. If you live in the dark room, will you be okay? So I said, all right, I will stay in the dark room. The first two or three days while I was giving aptitude test, I stayed in the dark room. And then I got admission in a hostel, so that is how I moved into Baroda. Well, here is the difference. You see, Surendranagar, with all its, you know, educational institutions, school, my friends, my teachers and all, was still a very kind of a, what shall we call it, socially a very constricting place. I mean, you make friends, but our friends are mostly men friends, you know, boys. Baroda was a kind of a great jolt, because here you came in contact with women, you And at a very personal level, you know, it was almost immediate, you know, that you sat together, walked together. And these girls came from all over India. They were all either English speaking or Hindi speaking. Few of them were Gujarati speaking. So in a way it was both a kind of a national kind of a school where you had literally mini India. And then of course we had both Europeans and even Americans, teachers and visitors.